morning, everybody. And today we have, we start our morning session with two last lectures by Professor Hsu. So please, the first one.
The next talk I'm going to talk about is cubic four order Hamiltonian and four order Hamiltonian kinetic or Hamiltonian lace for graphs. I'm always a kid. You know? Here is a snake, and the donkey, and the dragon, and Fiona. And we want to find a Hamiltonian cycle. First, you get the donkey, then you get the dragon, then Fiona, then go back. You can reallocated the these two vertices, these four vertices, and play the game again and again. Okay, so this is called four order Hamiltonian, and you can generalize it as a k order Hamiltonian graph. Okay.
So what is the definition? What is the definition of four-order Hamiltonian cycle?
The four-order Hamiltonian, okay. That's the definition,
I
think. Yeah. I gave it later. That's the definition for four-order Hamiltonian. It's in general graph theory. A graph is k-order Hamiltonian. For every k-order set, is there exist a Hamiltonian cycle which encounters S in the designated order? And later, I will call a graph is also proposed by in this paper. K vertex Hamiltonian connected means you have a given set, K set, and you want Hamiltonian paths begin with X1, ended with SK, but you must traverse this vertex in the designated order.
Oh, I see. This means that the order is very important in this case.
Yeah, the order is.
I see.
Yeah. So let's think about this is the problem. And why begin with four order? Because three order Hamiltonian make no sense. You have a Hamiltonian cycle. You can every Hamiltonian is Hamiltonian cycle. Every cycle is three cycle. You know, you can backward forward or backward. Trivial. So it is trivial. So, why I will begin with four order, maybe five order, right? So, let's try this one. It cannot be five order. Because once you go out, you can never return. Can you? One, two, whatever, you go three, four, then you have no way out, no way in. Yeah, I think young
so
boy.
Is it true for any cubic graphs?
Yeah, sure.
So this is just example, but it is true for any.
Actually, you can generalize this concept. Is maybe if you are studying k kinetic graph, the order at most k plus one. The order connected Hamiltonian is just increased by increased one. Yeah, at most one more. Oh, well, it is definitely, what is the relationship with my previous talk? It means it is definitely 184 tolerant Hamiltonian. And this is proof with our word, one picture, right? Because this is, suppose this one is 4, you just assign this is number 3. And this is one number one, number three, then two, four. Right? So any Hamiltonian cycle is you cannot go this one three, yeah. So I as I mentioned,
What is the problem from which this mathematical problem comes?
I don't know.
You don't know.
I don't know why they come.
Yeah, why?
I don't know why. But it's to me just the paper in 1997 they told me this one may be the only one. Might be the only two, not only one, the only two. He only find two examples. Then he discussed a graph with sufficient number of ages, they have some nice property, like all Shvatov type result. Okay? I don't know. Well, and he challenged us to see if there exist, you know, maybe k regular, k plus 1 Hamiltonian graph or k plus 1 Hamiltonian kinetic graph in their paper. And he asked, maybe k equal to 3 is maybe the most challenging one. Most challenging one, and let me tell you the result first. Maybe the result. Oh, I'm sorry. I should be here. This one. Actually, this graph is known as Euler graph. Euler graph. I think you like this graph. You like this graph. No problem. Okay, this graph is four order Hamiltonian. But it is checked in 2008. So it's from 1997 to 2007. It's a long period that took. I don't know why. But can you find another one? I don't know. It is vertex transitive and a very beautiful graph, right?
It is also bipartite.
Yeah, it's also bipartite. Yeah, it's also bipartite. Yeah. So let me tell you. So maybe I tell you my result. So this is the original paper. Then in 2008, a professor in MIT, the new result. And later, the generalized Peterson graph is four-order Hamiltonian, even don't leave, n is even, and n equal to 18, or n greater than 24. So I already find a branch of such graph. Well, they are bipartite. So, and actually for a while, I just think maybe, but when I see the Hewitt graph, I think the result must be very symmetry. So it must be vertex transitive or something like that. Okay. However, the Hewitt graph is Hamiltonian, but the generalized Peterson graph is not. But for a while, I think it must be vertex transitive. So I have also done something about vertex transitive. However, I do find some not vertex transitive. And can we find another some like a generalization of Hewitt graph? Then I give a set of key caudal ring. Caudal ring is you have two m vertices in a cycle. You connect one, all the distance one here, all distance one backward and forward, all distance one. And K must be an, I think, can master be an, I didn't indicate that, K must be an odd number. K must be an odd number. So every even vertex you jump K, and every jump K forward, and every odd you backward K. So you know the Hewitt graph actually 14.15. Let me see the Hewitt graph again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you arrange the graph in a cycle. The even vertex plus 5. In other words, the negative the odd number plus 5 and odd even number minus 5. Yeah. Okay. So this is the Hewitt graph. Then. So the caudal ring, I have a classification of the caudal ring 15 is four order Hamiltonian, is in n, 2n is equal to 12k plus 2 or 12k plus 10. Okay? So I have a classification of In Wu's paper, Wu's paper and the Schwarzen paper, he also mentioned the problem of K order Hamiltonian kinetic. I mean the K order Hamiltonian kinetic is the problem of K Hamiltonian kinetic. You must traverse these vertices in the order, beginning with the beginning vertex is x1 and the terminate vertex is sk. And Pn3 is four order Hamiltonian kinetic even only n is odd, and n is 15, and n greater than 19. So since this one is n is odd, so this is not Hamiltonian relatable. This is not bipartite. This is not bipartite. So I have a lot of example four order Hamiltonian kinetic, but not four order Hamiltonian, right? So the next question is, can you find this paper, four order Hamiltonian, even only n greater than 17 and n is not equal to 20, and it is four order Hamiltonian kinetic if n greater than 17. So I have a lot of four order Hamiltonian and the four order Hamiltonian kinetic graph. But there is an example which is four order Hamiltonian kinetic but not four order Hamiltonian. I don't know why. I don't know why, but the computer tell me that the result. Again, this graph is not a vertex transitive. So, can you find some vertex transitive graph? So,
excuse me. Does this mean that you don't know of any other examples?
But I do know some examples. Yeah. I mean, but this one. I will tell you. Up now, I don't have other. Up to now, I don't have any other, but I do know one is a cube kinetic cycle with computer result is a CCC5, CCC5, and maybe I have another called generalized Hamiltonian torus, which is for the Hamiltonian, but for the Hamiltonian lace ball. This is bipartite graph. So, what is CCCN? I think CCCN is a carry graph. Well, I think you
may feel familiar with this term.
It's a carry graph of group acting a binary word of length n generated by the group element that is located in the bit of a word on one position left, rotating the bit of a word, one position right, and they invert the first bit of a word.
Could you please?
Yeah.
There is examples, right?
Pardon?
I just was asking about any example of this kind of came from.
Yeah. The missing aid here. I missed some aid here. You shrink the cycle, you will get a hypercube.
Yeah.
You shrink the cycle, you get a hypercube. So you may be interested in this graph. I was very curious in this graph. Because I do find one is vertex transitive graph, but I cannot. I guess one more should be CCC7. But I cannot use my computer. It's too huge. It's impossible for me. It is impossible, totally impossible. And I will conjecture. If you want some, maybe some mathematics stuff, conjecture. CCCN with n equal, when n is odd, and n must be greater than 5. 3, definitely no. There are some reason. There are some reason that definitely no. But not computer reason, basic reason. So maybe I can go back and check some basic reason. So first, you know CCC3, they have a three cycle. And three cycle is the reason. Any cubic graph with a girth of three, definitely no. The reason is, here is a three cycle. You just 1, 3, 2, x, then try to find any Hamiltonian cycle in that order. I would say no. Okay. 1, you must go this way to avoid this one. To avoid, to get 2, you must get something like that. You get 3, then you get stuck. Right? So this is a simple reason of CCC3 is not work. I think maybe can understand what I'm talking about. Okay, actually, the girth of any cubic for the Hamiltonian cycle must be at least 4, or at least cannot be 4. It must be more than 4. Here you have a 4 cycle, and I ran 1, 2, 3, 4, and. Try to find your answer, then I think it is impossible, because for these two, then to get this one, 2, 4 it cannot use, so you have this, and 1, 3 you cannot, this 8, 1, 3 you cannot use it. You have already has a short cycle, right? So you have, I can give you a list of 4 order Hamiltonian. This is a generalized Peterson graph. And I think this is a Hewitt type graph. No, I must delete this graph.
But is it the full list?
No, pardon, I must delete this graph. This graph is, pardon?
Is it the full list or are there any other examples?
Pardon?
Are there any other examples?
I think this grammar is wrong. Pardon?
Oh, okay.
You might say it again.
Yeah, I'm just asking, are there any other examples of the examples? Or it is the full list?
No.
No.
Definitely no. You can still work on that. This is really just the beginning, the beginning of my work. Yeah. So if you are asking vertex transitive graph, well, just the beginning, and I don't know. Actually, yeah, everything is very beginning. So I think the drawing is. This drawing must be wrong. I must recheck it. So how about four-order Hamiltonian connected? This four-order Hamiltonian connected. This is Harry Potter. He must get the magic. I don't know what magic stick or magic hat. Then fight with Voldemort. So here is the solution, and as I told you, the problem is four order Hamiltonian connected. You can always play the trick again and again and again. Okay, so we can have a lot of four order Hamiltonian connected. Three order, it makes no sense. 1, 2, 3, definitely. You 1, 3, 2, definitely you must travel it. Any Hamiltonian connected is three order, right? So make no sense. So five order is impossible. It's impossible in this way. Four is here, and you surround it. Four is you cannot. Once you enter four, then you are dead. Okay, you cannot five, cannot be five. And I will show you that every four order Hamiltonian connected, cubic four order Hamiltonian connected, is one H4 tolerant Hamiltonian and one vertex four tolerant Hamiltonian. That must be something related what I have done before. So why it is 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian? Random. Suppose any age is 40, I pick 1H40, and then I ran the vertex. I think the proof, maybe proof without word. Okay? So how about one vertex 4? Can you prove it? Can you prove it? Yes, suppose I arrange 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. Then I must travel it in this way. Then you see what is the relation of, you can see more clear what is the relation of 3 and 4, the relation is adjacent to vertex 2. So I get 1 vertex 4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Okay? So it is 1H4 tolerant Hamiltonian. Again, 4 order Hamiltonian connected. The smallest, the girls must be at least five more, at least five. Yeah. Three is impossible. Here is the reason. Three is impossible, and four is impossible. Here. Okay, the same reason. And. I must rejoin, the student give me the wrong picture, I must rejoin. And actually, yesterday I had told you a concept of adjoin. You can adjoin it, doesn't still working.
So it is not vertex transitive, and you can give a lot of a branch of very very random graphs. I think this is a construction. You can repeat the process. You use A and join A join with other again. But I still typing the paper. Yeah. Okay. So again, you can say how about the four order Hamiltonian lace form, because in this bipartite we have working about bipartite version. So how about four order Hamiltonian lace form? So if you are talking about four order Hamiltonian giving k vertices, maybe k vertices, but the beginning vertex S1 and the ending vertex SK must be different partite set, then that's the only restriction you are given, right? So can you find other for the Hamiltonian lace form? I didn't color the vertex, but it is. No, I think the left graph is wrong. I must redraw it. This is a very interesting family. I call it. It is long as a. It is long as. Hamiltonian torus. You see, this is Hamiltonian. The six the head. So this is a two-dimensional Hamiltonian. So can I have one more high dimension? No? I have some high dimension. This one. It is not only vertex transitive, but also intransitive.
What is the definition of this graph?
The definition of this graph. I think you do make interesting. Yeah. So I tell you the generalized Hamiltonian torus. The generalized Hamiltonian torus, you have something like this. You have some color and some row. And the number of rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, must be even, and I think better than at least 6. Maybe, yeah. Okay, then you make a brick pattern. Okay? Then you make a circle. It is almost a cubic, except some boundary. Then you take a slope, and okay. This is called generalized Hamiltonian torus, and this one is a generalized Hamiltonian torus 6, 6, 0. And if you, this is another generalized Hamiltonian, but this should be maybe 4, 6,
then I don't know. Then this one is for this one. Actually, is for this one is actually generalized polynomial products of 3, 18, and 9. The definition of the Hamiltonian torus, maybe you from everyday point of view, then will be very, very tedious. Yeah, something like this. You first draw the Hamiltonian hexagonal mesh. Means you don't have any the wrap around A. Then you join the edge wrap around A later. But it is vertex transitive and A transitive. And I believe they have a lot of maybe you may be interested in a lot of chemistry applications maybe because the Hamiltonian. Yeah. Let's see what I want. So I hypothesis that CCN is a four order with four order Hamiltonian. If n is odd and the four order Hamiltonian and the four order CCN is odd with n greater than four is both four order Hamiltonian and four order Hamiltonian connected, and the CCN is four order Hamiltonian and four order Hamiltonian lazable if n greater than six, we cannot say four because you have a four cycle. Four cycle is forbidden. Yeah. And Hamiltonian match, Hamiltonian n is four order Hamiltonian and four order Hamiltonian lazable if n is not two. This is just a hypothesis because one definitely true because this is one Hamiltonian one is actually K33. Actually, I suppose K33. Can you find any other vertex transitive and A transitive four-order Hamiltonian and four-order Hamiltonian kinetic graph? You have one example is K4, but can you find any other? I don't know. Yeah.
Did you try to check K graphs on the symmetric group?
Yeah, that's why I know the picture, then I try to run computer. Maybe I don't know. Yeah, this is you give me the picture, then I use computer to run. It makes sense. But then if I read all your stuff, then totally impossible because take me to do a lot of reading to understand your structure. Yeah. And So far we have several examples that is four order Hamiltonian connected, but not four order Hamiltonian. But is it finite or infinite? Can you find infinite number of such graph? I don't know. I don't know. It's still a problem, right? Similarly, Hewlett graph is the only example I found
this is four-order Hamiltonian, but not four-order Hamiltonian Lisboa. The Hebrew graph is not four-order Hamiltonian Lisboa. But it's the only one I have found up to now. I don't know. Yeah. And similarly, the generalized Petersen graph 24 is the only three regular four-order Hamiltonian connected graph, not four-order Hamiltonian.
Yeah, what was the way to find out? Did you use computer to check it?
Well, yeah. I the only thing I can do it is now is computer to do that. Yeah, that's I'm in Providence University. I know, you know, the my students is not that competitive with others. So the only thing I think we can run computer, try. Yeah. And Honeycomb two. It's a vertex transitive, H transitive for the Hamiltonian Lisboa, but not for the Hamiltonian. Is that the only one? Is that the only one? Maybe you can ask. Yeah. So that's the topic. Any question? Maybe.
So what is the main open question in this direction? What is the main one? The main open question.
The main open.
Yeah.
Well, I think the main one, or to me or to.
Yeah.
For you. Oh yeah, for me. Oh. After I work on that, I will try to construct the K. Well, I mean, I will do maybe four. The next step I will do four regular, five star. You know. I think, you know, the only way I can do it should be like you have a nice graph in Cartesian with K two. You will get higher. This, right? It must be do this way. If I have energy, I will try this one. For those problems, using computer, cannot do anything mathematically. And only the nice graph can generate nice graph. So I just Cartesian program. Cartesian product with K2. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, any other questions? Let us set speaker for this first lecture of the morning session. So we have 15 minutes break.
Sorry.
Well, it's okay. Yeah.